Hi, BookTube. I'm filming this haul just so that I can get rid of all the piles of books. That's right there. So let's just film this. I actually don't really know when this will come up because this will be all the books that I've gotten through August. Did I do a book haul in for August? I don't know. But this entire autumn and December. So there's a lot of books. However, I will start with the six ebooks that I've got. The first one is The Sword of Mercy and Wrath by N.C. Cousins. This is a new release. It sounded interesting, so and it was some kind of sale, so I got it. It was a while ago I got it, which sounds ages ago. It's newly published, but none of these I got like in December. It was earlier, and then I got a series. Because the entire series were free when I put it, or it was like a dollar. I put it up as free because I put it in today. And they are, I don't remember what the series was called, but the author is Rebecca Grundon. And the books are A Touch of Death, A History of Madness, A Promise of Return, A Dance of Lies, and A Time of Prophecy. And they are post-apocalyptic sci-fi books, and the other one I don't remember. It's fantasy, probably. So now let's start with the books that that I have read first. So the first one I've already read is Spy X Family, story and art by Tatsuya Endo. This is volume 4, and this one I read after volume 5. I love this series. It's very heartwarming and wholesome. I think you have already seen how long this video will be. I will not go into details about the books. And then I got The Very Secret Society of Irregular Witches by Sango Mandana. This is a paranormal book in which a woman starts to teach kids. It's pretty funny. I love that there were not a miscommunication trope in this. Love that part. Other than that, this one was very much film based, but no details. I'm gonna put them back in my pile of need to do a wrap up pile. Then I have one that I'm technically currently reading, and that is Snökat Prinsen. I want there to be an S for my brain. But yeah, graphic novel, it's adorable. I got stuck and have not gotten past chapter one. But it's adorable. Okay, next, as a Christmas present for myself, I got the other books about folk tales because I think, yeah, after number 5, that was when the price started to kind of creep up, but number 6, number 7, yeah, those were expensive, comparatively at least. So I got number 2, which is romance. It's also the pink one. Then we got number 3, which is Jycken. You know, in medieval times, the person that could make fun of the king at the court and the king couldn't kill him. Basically, like the fool in the Farseer trilogy or that realm of the Elderlings, it's that character. And they're heavy. Then we have Ullitteratur from literature. That's number 5. So that was number 2 and 3. Then we have number 6, which is Gudar och människor, Gods and Humans. And then Ur oknytens värld. I try to look up how to, like, I know what it means, but it's like the evil or the, not just mischievous, but like the evil mischievous fae creatures. So like not a gnome, but like the slightly more, like an imp instead? I don't know. I know the Swedish ones. Then I have two books that I got on the book fair that I did films or footage of and planned to do something with, but never did because I probably wouldn't have gotten these any otherwise. So this is Poems in Selection and Stories in Selection, or more Fairy Tale in Selection by Zacharias Topelius. The main reason why I got them was because apparently this is the person who wrote Sov du lilla vidung and other like that's a pretty famous, like we have put music to it, and it's like, yeah, it's a bedtime story, bedtime story, bedtime song. And so I got them, and this is a Swedish Finn. So then I got one comic or comic adjacent. This is Fabio Joachim's Liv. So this is like the second of these books. I have the first one, but this is one, like it's inspired by the Gold Rush. This is by Don Rosa, or however you're supposed to say his name. And I swear this is just. He was at this fair 2013. I saw him. Didn't react. And I was like, oh yeah, it's him. He who makes some of my favorite Donald Duck stories or Uncle Scrooge stories. I'm still regretting it. But yeah, I have this one. I'm really excited for it. Then we have manga. Spy X Family, Volume 6. I got fired as a court wizard, so now I'm moving to the country to become a magic teacher. That time I got reincarnated as a slime, Volume 20 by Fuse. Oh, and the Fired as a Court Wizard is by story by Rui Sekai and art by Koyu Kitasawa. And this is created by Fuse and art by Taki Kawakami. Then I got Volume 5 of By the Grace of the Gods, story by Roy and art by Ranran. So those are these four. And we got more volumes of One Piece. The missing volumes, basically. So we have 4 through 6, 7 to 9, 12 and 14. So now I have all the volumes up to number 40. And then I got volume 1 and 2 of The Way of the House Husband by Kusuke Ono. I got two. I've heard so many good things about this, and it sounds hilarious. Non-fiction, Guardian for the Zombie Apocalypse, How to Grow Your Own Food When Civilization Collapses, or Even If It Doesn't, by Isabel Lloyd and Phil Clark. And this is just what it sounds like. And then we have Svart Historia by Amat Levin, Black History. This is, well, he's a Swede, he talks about like what has happened in Africa in general, not just like a bypass to what happens in Europe and the States, basically. I think I will start a new parallel, just saying. Then I got Den uppfinningsrika planeten, Biomimikry, Naturens lösningar på vår tids utmaningar by Fredrik Moberg. So this is the adventure, the imaginary planet, like biomimicry. So it's like, okay, the nature solution on for our times challenges. It just sounded pretty good, and it's about when biologists are working with engineers, architects, and designers to like mimic what nature have already done. It sounded interesting, so I got this. And then we have Jorden, vår tidshistoria, vår planets historia och framtid by Johan Rockström and Owen Gaffney. And I just realized that Greta Thunberg have written a foreword. I did not see that. I do not care. And this is about our planet's history and the future of it. Den nächsten, varför just jag, om att överleva avsnitt 1, Nottingham och Vattenstedt, by J.S.A. Kasikowski. This is extractions from a book that the person who is on his cover, that his dad wrote. His dad wrote the book Arbete ger frihet, so arbetsmarknadsfri. And he said, because he was there with the book, he said that he wanted to extract the pieces that were about everyday lives there. So that's what this one is. So what you did for every day, not just the horror. And he also said that he tried to make it a bit more palpable for today's audience, because his dad basically just wrote the chapter where Auschwitz won and things like that, or Auschwitz number 7, and then he just wrote other things. So you can actually buy his dad's book still, but so this is how his dad traveled. So that was interesting. And so this is his dad's dead, and this is from when his dad went around in schools to talk about his experiences. My throat hates me right now, but let's just continue. I have so many more books to go through. Okay, then I got a sequel, so that's good. This is Modern Väsenologi, Vårtidsväsen, Ingela Korsell and Rein Rosenberg. This is a modern crypto. I have no, I'm too tired, I'm too sick, but it's about modern creatures. But yeah, so vampires, even though that's an old creature, zombies, that's probably more present. And then I am missing one book, and that's more Väsenologi. So there's Väsenologi, so just this title, then there's more Väsenologi, and then this one is the modern one. So I might actually get the other one first before I continue on, so to speak. But the last one I have here is also a sequel. Tänk om 2 by Randall Monroe. What if 2? So the first one, basically, this is a person who used to work for NASA, I think. Yeah. He's a physicist and has done research at NASA, and basically on his blog he answers stupid questions as if they were serious questions. I love that book, and I also got them. I'm not wearing my glasses right now because the glare from this one, but I have read both of the ones earlier that he had put out, so yes, I'm looking forward to getting to this as well. Middle grade. Oh, I'm just exhausted. Furthermore, by Darren Simpson. This is a portal fantasy, if I remember correctly. And something about the fact that his dead sister is alive in this other world. I first heard this from Gavin, from How to Train Your Gavin. And I then just, because he had an arc or something, and I just kept on looking on the author's page until he actually could write, "Hi, it's now published." But yeah, looking forward to getting to this. It sounded really nice, and I love the cover. Since we're talking about How to Train Your Gavin, let's continue. Orion Lost by Alastair Chisholm. This is a middle grade sci-fi, which I have actually not read before. At least not that I can, like, recall, but they are millions of miles from home and someone is lying to them. One of his favorites, and I'm also hoping that I will like that one. Then I got Gargantuous and Shadow Ghast by Thomas Taylor. This is book 2 and 3 in, I think this is just a trilogy in the Arion Sea mystery series. I loved Malamander, so I wanted the other two books as well. And then I got the first book in a series or something. This is a Swedish book. Rebellernas geni, Elden under ytan. I don't know if that's the title name or if that's the title name and if one of them is the series name. I have no idea. Let me just see. No, it's exactly the same on the inside. The Rebellion's Genius, Fire Under the Surface, and it's about someone who probably found something magical, and you're not supposed to have anything magical in this place. So yeah, this was one that I got on the book fair, so it is also signed. And then there were a Instagram or something there. She gave out books for free. So this is The Sunken City by Emma Bearden Jones. And this is about someone that's a pirate and something that they hate, magic. And it turns out that she might be a mermaid. Don't know. Sounded fun and it was free, so I was like, yeah, sure. And it is also signed. Two more middle grade, Swedish middle grade. The first one is another sci-fi one, actually. This series is Mutanterna. Actually, this is. No. Oh, should this one. Yeah, this is a weird. I mean, it's a nice mixed, but whatever. So, this is by Ingela Korsell and Daniel Thulin. And this is a. Well, we are following a person who has a mutation. And someone is trying to find all these mutated children. So, they need to run for their life. And this is, well, it's called The Mutants. This book is Experiment. And this has a mixture of normal text, but also comic sections. So it's like a mixed media thing. And then we have Svartskogens Hemligheter. So the series is Svartskogens Hemligheter. And this is called Svartskogen, so The Black Forest Secrets. And this is Black Forest again, first book. And this is based on fairy tales. But this story, if I understand correctly, is by Helena Voss and the art is by Johan Erik Hans. And I love his art style. So I'm trying to find something. So yeah. So yeah. Looking forward to that one as well. Okay, fantasy. The biggest stack, and then I have two stacks left. Great. First, let's talk about these. Now, in Swedish, especially like 90s, early 20s, a lot of the translated works were then divided into several books. That's the case that what happened with books by Tad Williams, the first one being The Dragonborn Share. I need one book. I have ordered it, so it's on its way. But we then have the second book that I don't remember what it's called. Here it is. So three books, Stone of Farewell. So we have Storm Saga, Stormens Hand and Stormens Hjärta. So this is book number two. And this is book number three, except for book one that I've also ordered. Let's see here, what is the third book called? To Green Angel Tower. Memories are on Thorn. There we go. Although when I say it comes in three parts and then it's like one, two, three, four, five, six. So I have them. I love how it say in the first book, it come in three parts. No. Okay, let's just continue on so I get finished. Holy. Yeah, I just looked at the clock. The Songbird Trials by Aidan Thomas. This is a. Was it Mexico? Nevertheless, I enjoyed The Cemetery Boys. It was a nice break, but I definitely need to be in the right mindset for YA. Otherwise, I will just hate them or be very disappointed. But I'm crossing my fingers that I will like this because The Cemetery Boys was just what I needed at that point. Next, I have The Kingdom of Liars by Nick Martell. This is a story in which we are following a person who was exiled with his family and now he's like gambled and things like that to get by, but he gets a chance to go to court and then things obviously happen. Then we have one that I haven't even read the back except for the top line, and that's where I will leave it. And that is Goblin Quest by Jim C. Hines. I loved the. I still have to read one book, but oh, what's the series called? The Yantras of Post-Apocalyptic something. I will talk about the third book because it's coming when I get to sci-fi. But yeah, this is another work by him, and I'm crossing my fingers that I will like it. And first line is, Yig the Goblin was the vauntiest member of an admittedly puny race. I'm not even gonna read more. I want to read it. Then we have Tread of Angels by Rebecca Rohnhorst. It deals with like descendants to demons, fallen angels, and normal angels. And I have been on like an angel kick lately, so I just need to read it to like fulfill that part of it. Then we have Map's Edge by David Hare, and this is about someone who flees to the edge of the map, but finds some kind of map or something to find something by going through the ruins of an ancient long dead civilization. And obviously, they're being hunted. Sounded really cool, and I wanted it. Then we have Grave Importance by Vivian Shaw, which is the third and so far. And the author hasn't said that she will publish more, but it's the Doctor Greta Helsing series, and this follows a doctor for the undead. Basically, I had a lot of fun with the other two, so I would like to finish this. And then we have The Inheritance of Oqueda Divina by Soledad Cordova. I really enjoyed The Long Way to Rio Luna by her, so I'm crossing my fingers that I will like an adult instead, as well, I mean, and something about this grandmother dying, getting an hint, yeah, things happen, mysterious things. I'm hoping that I will like it. Then I got the last book in the Dragons. Actually, I think it's. Is it called just Dragon Ultimate? I don't remember what this book is called, Dragon Ultimate by Christopher Rowley. I had to order this from the States because even though like the book was fairly decent price, but the shipping was ridiculous, but it was still like not even a quarter of what I would have to pay it if I bought the Swedish edition or like a Swedish edition, the one that was available to Amazon in Sweden. But this is the last book, so now I have all seven of them. And I have not started it, which is probably very stupid. But yeah, it is called Basic Broke Tale. And Basic Broke Tale is the dragon in question. Then I got Obsidian Awakening by Sienna Frost. This is a fantasy in which we're following seven different people who are broken for some reason. I don't remember that much about it, but I do remember that there are illustrations in this. So I am. Yeah, there's sometimes they're bigger, other times there's like a noose, and that's the only thing. But yeah, I'm. Yes. Have heard a lot of good things about this one, The Black Tongue Thief by Christopher Bullman, and another one. You're following a thief in this one. I am so tired. And then we got Ruination by Anthony Reynolds. This is apparently a League of Legends novel. Didn't know that, but whatever. Could be fun. But I guess this looks so pretty. And there's the sword as well. But yeah, got this one. We're almost done. We're almost done. Sci-fi. This Spare Man by Mary Robinette Kowal. This is the same author that wrote The Calculating Stars. I really enjoy that one. Need to continue on with The Fated Sky. And this one is a mystery on a interstellar spaceship in which a murder happens and the main character's husband's being accused of it. This is actually our next buddy read. Then we have the first book in the Artilleryman series, Purgatory's Shore by Taylor Anderson. This just sounded hilarious. Like, on the way to fight in the Mexican-American War, a group of American soldiers is swept away to a strange and deadly alternate Earth in this thrilling new blah blah blah. Basically, you're following these people who are on a planet where there's dinosaurs. It just sounded hilarious. I needed it. Okay, I will actually end with this one for this pile. Then I have the Illumina Crate as well. I will end with that book. Then I have Hyperion by Dan Simmons. This is a sci-fi classic. A lot of people love this. So I decided when it was cheap, where I got it, I don't remember. It probably was because otherwise I would probably just be like, let's borrow it from the library. But I've heard so many good things about it, and it's on a lot of list of like best sci-fi. Then I have The Lost Fleet by Jack Campbell. It sounded nice. It sounded interesting. And yes, I am aware that this Beyond the Frontier. This could be that this is not the first. Yeah, this is not the first book, so I will have fun with that. The Lost Fleet, Dauntless. Oh well. Just six more books to buy before I can get to this one. That happened. I think it actually is. Yeah, because it's called Book One here. That's what they do on the SFF bookstore. They write down the first. So I think that was why I didn't look into it, because it's the first book in the new series, so it counts. Terminal Peace, Book Three of the Janitors of the Post Apocalypse by Yim C. Hines. I finally have it. I am so scared of it. I did read the first chapter because the author put it up on his web. Site, or maybe not the entire first chapter, but I'm just gonna go double check. No, I did read the entire first chapter. Yeah, so I'm kind of scared, but I'm loving this series. When we were at the book fair, me and my dad, we had worked on my brother, so that let's leave about 5, or like something like that. Like, let's leave early because he wants to be there until they close at 6. That's also when the worst traffic will be, because everyone who needs to leave will leave them. So we had finally worked that through. I go around, finally see, because every year I tell myself that I will look and see what books the what authors the SFF stall will have. At 5 o'clock, they had Nnedi Okorafor. So I bought this, and this is signed. I freaked out. Like, she was also having like a panel discussion or like an interview thing right next door. I couldn't like hear anything, and I didn't care, because like, if we had been there longer, because basically my dad was like, fine, go get that sign and then just leave. And I would have sat there and listened, but I needed to be in the line. So I heard some things, but there were so much people there, and I was third in line. And I'm so freaking out. I'm still freaking out. Four more books, the Illumicrate ones. Or the ones that I have gotten from Illumicrate, because I know I haven't gotten all of them. I think I skipped two. Yasuna. I actually don't remember if I mentioned The Drowned Woods by Emily Lloyd-Jones. This edition is very nice and pretty with reverse dust jacket. It sounds interesting, and but yeah, it's about revenge. Then we have The Whispering Dark by Kelly Andrew. Just look at that. Do you see the skulls? It looks so cool. I love this cover. But this is again a... We are following a deaf protagonist. It's supposed to be like dark, but it's just... It looks stunning. So yeah, I don't really remember much about it when I looked it up, from when I looked it up, but it looks amazing. Then we have The Illuminaries by Susan Dennard. Another beautiful edition. Stunning. And this one is about like a hidden city. And something about wanting to join a group of people that are protecting the town from the danger in the forest around them. My voice hates me. My voice hates me. Okay, last one. This is the December Limit Crate. If you have not gotten yours, turn this one off, but I don't know when this will be posted, because holy crap, this is 44 minutes right now. But The Red Scholar's Wake by Aliente Bodard. I've heard a lot of good things about this author, and some like mixed things as well, because that's how life is. It's pretty, as they all are. And yeah, and this one, it's an AI, a ship AI, so it's definitely up my wheelhouse. I love AIs, who propose a marriage between herself and this other people who is a bot maker and a mother, so definitely adults. And wants to protect its people, or their people. I don't really know. The reviews are kind of mixed, but yeah. It's a nice round number, at least. 64. And I'm counting the two I have finished and the one that I'm technically currently reading. And then we also have the six ebooks, so 70. You understand why I changed it from 100 to get them to under, because like these books are like the reason. Now if I had actually read 70 books in that time, it would make sense. How many have I read from, let's say, August? How many books have I read since August? 22. So I have bought almost 50 books from two. 50 books too much. What's the best book that you got, or the book that you're most proud of that you got or didn't get this autumn? What's the book that you're like, I got a hold of this, I loved it, or why the fuck did I buy it? You can pick. What a favorite book of yours, or a book that for you is infamous in your life. I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm too tired. Blah. But yeah, see you next time. Bye.